hope everyone is well. Random pop-up stream, as usual. Is that me? Yeah, it's me. You know it's me, bud. Thank you for joining. Thanks for watching the VOD. I know because I didn't have this planned, even for myself, that this is one that people might not get to because it is not announced. So thank you to the streamers who have put this on their automatic announcements. I appreciate you. You know, Odin's Eye Tarot, it goes off in his Discord. And I know I set it up in my Discord. But thank you to any of the streamers who have this set as an automatic command that goes off that lets people know that I'm on. I appreciate you. If you don't, you can follow my Twitter. It's the only platform that I can't change my name on, technically, and like my username, so it's Chucklesaurus Rex, still. My college, a fun college nickname I got. So I'm having chai tea this morning with coconut almond milk mixed in, so it's the perfect temperature. And this chai tea is like an instant powder chai tea, so it's got like granulated honey in it and instant black tea, so it'll still have a little caffeine, but not as crazy as actually brewing up black tea and adding all the spices. That's how I used to make my own chai tea and boil it on I had a really cool glass. Hi friends, welcome in. But I had a really cool glass, like coffee pot kind type thing, Kyrex like teapot. And so you could put it right on the gas stove and just turn it on and boil water in there. And I had little, like my little reusable tea mesh strainers, and I would put all the seasonings in there. So whole cloves and cardamom pods, and drop a, hi Taco, good to see you. Welcome in. Shout out Nebulous Taco, glad you're in here. Hi Crown, welcome in, good to see you. A couple wonderful streamers in here right now hanging out. Wow, it's so good to see you guys. Thanks for popping in with zero notice. I was just explaining, I was like, if you guys are not catching me live and you're watching the VOD, thanks for being here. We're just going to do the quick morning practice today for Qigong, and then I got to run to work. So we're going to try to fit it in, and if we can't, we can't. Thank you for using the emotes, they're so cute. If we can't, we can't, and what we get done, and that's the perfect practice for us. So, I'm gonna tilt my camera down a bit, because we're on mobile, as usual, in my living room, as usual. So I think if I stand back here, I should be good. I'm in my work outfit already, my work fit for the day. We'll do the spin. Oh, I think that chai tea is hurting my tummy. I gotta drink some water. That's too sugary this morning. No judgment. I did buy plastic water bottles. And I kind of feel like doing the seated practice today. My belly's kind of feeling like meh. So... oh, thank you. Welcome in. Glad you're here. Glad you jumped in here, even though no notice. Thanks for having your notifications on. I appreciate that. So I'm going to lower this down, actually, and we'll just do the seated practice. So we'll just be lazy. So if you're in bed, because it's a crazy time, like here, it's pretty early. So if it's too early for you and you're like, I don't really want to be, I want to be comfortable still. Or I guess no matter what time of the day, and you just want to be comfortable, that's fine. I should probably put a different outfit on for this, but it's going to be fine. I'm going to just stretch out and do some child's pose, so just do whatever your body's asking you to do. Oh my gosh. Yeah, that's fair. You're not usually awake at this time, what with usually finishing work 6 hours prior. Oh my gosh, yeah, usually you're probably sleeping. Yes, I did not get as much sleep as I wanted to last night, so that's how we're So here it is, the
right
self-healing
ball of the big toe.
Seated practice. So this is a great one for no matter what you're going through or where you're at in life. I'm going to turn the heat down so I don't forget before I leave. Heat's up here at 69 degrees. MSR, welcome in. Thanks for popping in here. The night shift will do that to you. It's true. Well, so this is a great practice, though, if you didn't get sleep and you want to feel a little bit better. So let me know if the sound is too quiet, but I'll put this over here using a yoga block.
Begin by bringing both hands in prayer position to the center of your chest. Long deep breaths.
Let me know if you can hear it.
Use the knuckles of your thumbs just to press into the center of the chest gently. This is a pressure point for emotional balance and relaxation. Then take the hands out in front of you, and we'll do a breathing exercise called the bear swimming. Inhale as the arms come apart, and exhale, extend the hands in front of you. Feel a little spiraling movement going through the arms, extending through the fingertips. As you exhale, sink your chest back. As you inhale, expand and open the chest. Feeling the swimming motion extend and stretch through all your tendons from your shoulder blades down through the arms. Do this one more time. Nice deep breath. Open the chest. Extend forward. And then reverse the direction, pulling in. Spiral around the other way. Inhale, coming into the chest. Exhale, the back of the hands towards each other. Deepen into your breath and relax into this flow. This flow stimulates and energizes the lung meridian. We say the lungs are the commanders of chi. That's why we start with deep breathing exercises. Now go ahead and bring the soles of your feet together in front of you and interlock your fingers around the toes. Let's do a movement called turtleneck and stretch the whole back of the body as well as the hips. Inhale and look up.
So,
exhale,
so
tuck the
feet
chin
together,
down.
We're doing turtleneck.
Rolling up on the inhale. Feel the stretching of the neck and the shoulders. A nice opening between the shoulder blades, down through the low back, the hips, and the waist. Connect the stretch and the movement with your breathing. Exhale as you come down. Nice deep breath as you come up. Just let it flow. This stretch opens the spine and that connection between the spine and the hips. Now hold the stretch. Bring your forehead down towards your toes. And if you can, comfortably bring your elbows in front of the shins. And take a deep breath and slowly roll up. Let's do some pressure points on the inside of the feet. Use your thumbs to massage the inside of the feet, the bottoms of the feet, all along the arches. All the points along the bottoms of the feet are good for mental relaxation and calming your mind. And now walk the thumbs up the back of the calves. Work them all the way up towards the knee and then come back down. These are all pressure points along the kidney meridian. Kidneys are good for energy, low back health, and hormone balance. Again, massage the bottoms of the feet. Work the whole bottom, the arches. This is great just to stimulate energy from the feet all the way up into the organs. Now with your fingertips, massage the top of the feet between the first and the second toe. There's a pressure point here. This is liver 3. It's great for headaches, keeping mental relaxation. Now walk the thumbs up the inside of the calves. This is the belly of the muscle, sort of the middle of the calf.
Are your eyes open?
The thumbs all the way up to the knees.
Can you even see what you're doing, Carly?
And then come back down.
I love you guys.
The liver meridian is good for the tendons, the muscles, and keeping the body flexible.
You're doing it, Mr. Krabs.
Now massage along the arch
of
the foot near the bone.
I said she, but I'm sorry.
Meridian line
here.
And then we'll come up the inside of the leg near the bone. Press the muscle away from the bone to stimulate the
bone. Is that too loud? Is it just loud for me?
Meridian. Pressure points here.
So So we're really just going up the legs, just massaging with our thumbs, going up the three meridian lines, so one behind the calf, one on the side of the calf, and one up by the shin bone. It sounds okay. Okay, good, good. Well, hopefully you feel all of these pressure points though. Now we're doing one hand at the base of our ankle, and there's a point just above that, about 4 inches up, and that's the three yin meeting point. So you can just massage right there on both sides. So full hand from your ankle to your lower calf, and that point on your lower calf is the point that you want to massage. So now you can put your feet down on the ground and up between the big toe and the second toe. There's like an indent, and you can kind of go about halfway up your foot on the top and press into that pressure point. And then directly underneath that, kind of the beginning of your arch under the base of the big toe, that ball area of the foot, that's a pressure point right there. So we're just doing some self-massage. These are great pressure points for all your different internal organ systems to allow that energy, any stuck or stagnant energy to flow. So our emotions, our traumas, every time we tense up our muscles, those muscles are releasing different hormones, different chemical cocktails, we called it when I was a psych major. And what that just means is that your body's remembering every time you have a trauma, every time you experience something that causes you fear or frustration or distress. And so by doing this practice, we're actually moving that energy through our body systems, moving it out of places that it gets stuck, like our hips, like our lower back, like our stomach, like our gut area, like when you have kind of that gut feeling. And ignore it and you know, walk into a stressful situation at work that you were expecting, that maybe you didn't feel like you could get away from, and we don't have like an adrenaline rush burn off after we fight with our boss, right? You just kind of sit there and deal with it and feel awkward and worry that you're going to get fired. And so even those little moments that we don't think of as traumas are. And this isn't to scare you and freak you out and say, oh my God, I've been through so much more things than I even realized. But maybe it is in a little ways. But not in a way that means to scare you, but in a way that means to say, like, hey, even if you don't think you've been through anything, or like you had a great childhood and life was good, like, have you been in a fender bender? Like, have you almost been in a car accident and stopped it and felt that kind of adrenaline rush that comes from, you know, avoiding a car accident? So, you know, it's kind of like these daily life stressors that we kind of blow off, that actually still need to be worked through our body and still need to be. So right now we're just massaging our lower back, our kidney area, down the outside of the legs, and then we're kind of holding underneath the spot, whether it's under your knees or under your calves. And then we're doing that turtleneck move again. So chin down to the chest, I'm breathing up, we're kind of stretching our neck upwards. So stretching down, breathing out, and then breathing in as we look up. And I'll turn sideways so that you guys can see kind of what my body's doing that way. So hands here, hands wherever feel comfortable to you. I like lower calf right now, feels good. So breathing out. So now we're going to do like a wide-legged stance. We're going to go push the energy down each leg. So really just leaning forward, gently pushing our hands, breathing out, and then breathing in. Breathing in new energy, exhaling as you push down, and breathing in towards the chest. And just Qigong is all about learning how to flow, learning how to be easy on ourselves, learning how to move this energy through our body. It's all associated with acupressure points and acupuncture, the meridian lines of the body. And so it's easy enough to do and to feel the benefits instantly. So you could do three or four times of doing these movements and feel better. So just allowing our bodies to open and stretch deeper. We're not trying to push or force. Every time you do these moves, your body becomes more and more flexible. Your joints work better. Your energy is flowing easier. And so your body moves easier. I didn't get this leg, but it's kind of going at your own pace.
Circular flow of energy going down the outside.
So this heat, we're just doing down the outside, up the feet, and up the inside. So this is our chi flow down our legs, down the outside of our legs and up the inside of our legs. So just that nice, easy flow. And you don't push yourself further than you need to. I've been doing this a few years, so my body's pretty flexible and fluid at this point. So this all feels like a great stretch for me. But there were days before that I couldn't stretch, you know, there's no way I could have done that. So do what feels good for your body. So then there's these pressure points on our legs. So you can feel that like tendon spot where it's kind of like wibbly wobbly. And then just below that is stomach 36. So the other one I think is
come across and we'll do the other side. Massaging stomach 36 with the thumb.
Stomach 36. Yeah.
Great point for your immune system and to increase the energy.
So this is an immune system point and to increase the energy. So this is like a life hack, essentially. That's what qigong is. It's, if life is going up the mountain, qigong is the map that gets us there. So it's going to get you there easier. Your body's going to work better. You're going to feel more connected to the earth, more connected to your own body. I didn't get this side, but so now we're just massaging. This is a great one. Just go around the ears and down the neck. So it's easier if you have short hair. It's easier if you don't have your hair in a bun like I do right now. And my hair is wet because I just washed it in the bath. But this is a great way to bring that good circulation down to your face, down your neck.
Do the front of the neck, the throat area.
I did that just in the slide down here. So our throat, our chi can get stuck here. So going around the ears and down the neck, down to the chest.
So go ahead and take a nice deep breath.
Take a nice deep breath there.
Sit with your legs crossed.
Now getting our legs crossed again, crisscross applesauce. That's what we used to call it.
Your thumbs.
So this is a great neck massage. So interlock the fingers. Firm pressure with the thumbs.
All those pressure points in the neck area.
And I'll turn around so you guys can see.
Good. Maybe go a little bit wider on your neck. Just get some of those muscles to the sides of the spine. Pressure points not only stimulate the meridian flow, but they bring good circulation into the muscles, clearing tension, tightness, knots, or contractions. Base of the skull, from the base of the skull all the way down to the top of the shoulders. This is a line of tension, and it helps to not only release neck tension, but also bring clear chi up into your brain for focus and mental clarity. Now just grab the back of the neck with your palm. This is called cat's paw. So just squeeze those muscles with the back of the hand. Pull up and away. Get the blood flow into the tendons around the neck joints.
Good for you as it does for me.
Sides, press your palms down and away from you. Lean the head.
Dan Devation and Leoric. Oh my God, good morning, you guys. Welcome in, friends.
Doing those pressure points.
Happy time zones. So we are just doing our quick seated qigong practice. So you can do this from bed. Just do a couple moves with us. We're just having our hands down and just stretching our neck. So rolling it back and forth over our shoulder very slowly, very gently. Not too far. Marky, I'm so glad you're here. I'm so grateful that you stopped up.
Feel the opening of the neck, front of the neck, and in the back of the neck.
You don't want want to push it too far. You just want to gently
down,
allow that
chest,
neck to get some good massages rolling
together
along.
With thumbs, flex the wrist towards the elbows, and press the back of the hands down. Slowly roll the head back and forth.
I didn't get
the left
sides
shoulder.
With my hands like this, but then you'll do fingers together, point it forward. And then you'll do, we'll do some same motion with our neck, the rolling gently back and forth.
To the other side. Head back and forth across the shoulder. Nice deep breath. Long exhale. Allow the muscles to release and flow. Back to the center. Relax your hands down to your lap.
Butt spot. Love all
now
butt
we'll
spaces.
Open the wrists. Make a little circular motion.
That's a good one, butt spot. That's silly.
Nice
Dandy, Dandivation, I'm so glad you're here. What a wonderful streamer you are. Thanks for popping in. So this one reverses arthritis. So highly recommend this. Teach it to your grandmothers.
Poor circulation or stiffness in the joints.
Teach it to everyone you know, because this is just a simple move anyone can do anywhere.
And then interlock your fingers.
Shake it out.
And do a wave-like motion.
Okay, this one's fun.
Outside of the arms and the inside of the arms.
We're doing the wave.
So this flow creates a balance.
It's called
of energy
the wave
between
flow.
The yin and the yang meridians.
So like Qigong was doing it first.
Feel how this wave
you guys
not
thought
only
this was a sports
wrist,
thing?
Also connects to your shoulders.
This is a Qigong thing. This has nothing to do with sports. This is
back
so beneficial and I'm so happy to catch you streaming. I'm so
right
glad you're here,
you
Dandy.
Circle.
Yes, so we're just circling our wrists now.
A little bit deeper into those joints.
Getting really deep into those joints, really feeling that flow and that flexibility moving in.
Movement into the shoulders by lifting
and then lifting
elbow
those elbows, doing a bear
around.
Swimming motion a little bit.
Use this swimming
or
motion here.
Rooster spreads its wings.
And shoulders.
That's what this one's called.
Joints,
so,
the arms
no matter what time of the day is, our rooster is getting
we'll
up.
Pressure points. Let's use the thumbs to massage along the inside of the arm.
So massaging
the
from
elbow,
the hand
and
to the to the wrist crease,
through to the lower part of the wrist,
to the elbow.
Now come up the middle of the forearm, all the way up to the elbow, and back down.
Oh.
Let the energy flow through the entire meridian from the elbow to the wrist. Come up now from the thumb to the upper arm.
So for whatever reason,
arm,
redheads have like super tough skin when it comes to like burning, like getting burned, like third degree burns and stuff.
Along the pinky
like our skin
arm,
heals really fast from it, and like
elbow,
oftentimes it doesn't hurt as much because of
pressure,
the like consistency of our
down,
skin or something. This is real facts, science facts.
Come to the center line,
I don't know all the details, but I know something like that.
The middle of the arm, all the way to the elbow.
But I just look at my arm, and I don't know if you guys can see this in the camera. Yeah, this is like a little like third degree burn. Like my skin's all like wrinkled and weird looking. I'm like, oh my god, Carly. You know that steam was hot. That was from the Instant Pot, this veggie steamer that I use to make potatoes. So knocking these together helps clear any emotional stuck energy that can cause physical problems. So it gets stuck in our body and causing disease. Just from our body not being, you know, strong enough. It also boosts our immune system, so this is great if you work at a place where you see a lot of people, if you are exposed a lot to germs, you work in a hospital. Just knocking your wrists together as you walk around, you know, doing your charts or whatever, you can kind of give yourself that little immune system boost. I think these are important things they should teach in schools, honestly. It's genetics. Redheads have a higher pain tolerance. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, birth was a breeze.
Now go from the center of the
I should not say that, but it really was. It was like, oh, are we done? No meds. Just, I had these two ladies massaging my legs with essential oils. It was awesome. Nicest women ever.
Stress and tension.
I had been watching their kids the whole pregnancy. I like ran this daycare with these two kids, or with like eight kids in it. But these two ladies' kids were there, and They were such sweethearts. And they were my doulas. Really, really cool. Highly recommend getting doulas if you're going to go through childbirth. But yeah, for the most part, breath work, meditation, no meds, hadn't smoked weed in a while. So it was intense, but it wasn't. I took a hot bath and I was like, this baby's coming, and I like got out of the bath and like waddled to the bed like holding my son, and I was like, this baby's coming, Mom. She's like, doctor, get in here. This is a great one, just rubbing your fingertips, your fingernails together. This is the end of a bunch of meridian lines, so it can like bring good energy to our body. Then we're massaging, doing the facial massage.
Facial rejuvenation is good for bringing life force energy into the face, rejuvenating energy into all the muscles. Now I'll come around the sinuses and just massage the sinus points near the nose.
So our sinus points are right here where you feel that sinus pressure. I do this. I used to do this for people. I dated a lot of people who had bad allergies or bad sinus issues. Especially in Michigan, it was rough between seasons. And I would just like give them little facial massages like this before I even knew about it. But I was just like, we just need to get that flow going. Get that like stuck. That stuck stuff, you know, mucus and whatnot that's built up. And just allow that to flow again. And it was just like, for me, it made sense, you know. It just made logical sense. You don't want things to be stuck and, you know, festering. So, Uncle Fester. I love the Addams Family. That's a fun fact about me. This is fun facts in Qigong. Did you know? This is a great one. So knuckles of the first finger, if you have headaches, migraines. This is a great pressure point.
Right under that
orbital ridge. Great self-massage to help us, or help our bodies work.
Now circle your knuckles right at the temples.
Look at how good our face can look.
Stress and tension.
Fresh, glowing.
Pressure points for headaches.
All I have is lotion on. Lotion on my lash extensions. I don't wear any makeup ever. Look at these rosy cheeks. I didn't sleep a wink last night, you guys. I shouldn't even tell you that. Jaw muscles. This one's really good if you have TMJ or if you clench your jaw a lot, you have like night terrors or something. This is a great one for helping relax.
Knock into the jaw right around the ear.
Do you guys ever just sing randomly? I do all the time. Oh, it's lovely. It really is. This is a 4,000-year-old self-healing practice. My teacher, who's discussing this right now, this changed his life. And I just bought his book finally, and I started reading it, and I was reading a story, and it brought me to tears. Like, he was a busy, stressed-out college student at Berkeley, so smart, top-rated soccer player, like, phenomenal athlete, but he was totally burned out and working too hard, and he found Qigong in college, seeing this woman who wasn't studying in a statistics class. Oh, do you feel that good warmth and energy that comes right into your face? Move again to the front. So from the ears, hovering over the ears, now we're hovering in front of the eyes. Breathing in deeply. And releasing with a sigh. Total relaxation and calming. Absolutely feel that. Thank you guys so much for being here. All right, hands over the lower abdomen.
So circle the hands in a big circle all the way around now, through the whole lower abdominal area and around the rib cage. Just bring some of that life force energy into your internal organs. And then circle the hands in the other direction, starting with the circle around the
ribcage
in the abdomen.
Excuse me.
Breathe into it.
Hey, Google. What time
feel
is that?
How the heat and warmth from the hands can open into the organs.
It's 6:55 a.m.
Make a smaller circle just around
gotta
the navel.
Gotta get going soon. Gotta
this
get
is
to work.
Centering energy, bringing energy into the lower dantian, that place of internal power, self-healing, and being centered. Take a deep breath. Feel a sense of relaxation and flow going through the lower abdomen. And then we'll lie down. So just go ahead and come down onto your mat.
I don't
the
think
floor.
I should lay down. Last time I
relax,
laid down,
we'll
I fell
do
asleep
a visualization
on stream.
For healing energy. Just get comfortable.
All right, 5 minutes on the
feel
ground.
Spine,
hey, Google.
Down on the floor.
Set alarm for 6 minutes.
Legs relaxed. Your arms,
there. Your alarm set for 7:02 a.m.
All right.
Take a moment just to soften through the back of the head.
Just cracked. Oh,
down through
so
the neck.
Nice.
Feel the face relax. The muscles around the jaw. Even the tongue relax. Surrender down into the earth. Feel supported by the earth, connected to the earth, and completely enhanced by this earth energy that's surrounding you. The earth has a way of embracing the energy of transforming stress, sick energy, or any problems in your body, transforming that back into vitality. Long, slow, deep breathing. Even relax into your breathing where you feel as if the air is breathing you. No effort or no strain. Visualize yourself lying on a beach somewhere beautiful, warm sunshine shining on your body. And as you're doing that deep breathing, just allow yourself to absorb this golden light. Absorb this golden light first through your face. Feel that sunlight, that golden light, shining and radiating on your face. Just draw it in, filling up every cell through the face with more light and more energy. Golden light is healing, transforms old energy into new energy. So as you're doing this visualization, anything that you need transformed, just use that golden light, use your breath, use the chi flow to transform it back into positive energy, back into healing energy. Now breathe this golden light down through the neck and the shoulder area. Let it flow into your muscles. Golden light as it goes into the muscles is like warm oil, working out tension, softening those muscles, creating suppleness and flexibility. Down through the spine, down to the muscles next to the spine, around the hips and the waist. All those muscles soft and relaxing. This nice flow down the back of the legs, all the way to the feet.
The drink.
Where that oil is.
Don't forget to hydrate,
just
friends.
Feel it working out.
Oh my god,
divination
station, I was just thinking right about you.
Full vitality.
Oh my god, so especially cool that you're here. I have loved your card reads of the day and like what your goddess of the day is. Oh my god, if you guys are not following Divination Station on Instagram, get your booties over there. Check out that story. Turn those notifications on for the story because they are cool every day. Oh my god. And your voice is so soothing and it's just like draws me in. I'm always like, where are they? I want more. Like withdrawal symptoms. So we're just doing a visualization at the end of our qigong, just imagining that golden light circulating through our body. Oh, creating a new one for today. Can't wait. Oh my god. The last one I saw was Zeus's wife, Hera. And I learned so much that day. And I was like, wow, that's so powerful. Like, learning that lesson of what serves us? What are we standing up for that's not even ours? You know, where do we need to have boundaries and let go of things that aren't for our highest good anymore? And not clinging and defending like we would normally do, but knowing that's not like part of who we are. Mex, what's good? Y'all, if you need some good music to listen to, Mex can play and sing pretty much any song that you want to hear, like throwbacks, new songs, like absolutely awesome guitar player. So shout out to that Mex guitar guy. Get over there, one of my Mission Gang members, one of the homies. Super good to see you, dude. I'm glad you're here. The Goddess deck was my first Oracle deck since I got back into reading tarot. Oh my god, that's what it is, the Goddess deck. I love it. I'm obsessed. Michigang, yeah. I gotta put that on some merch. We're picturing golden healing light entering our bodies. And we're also getting really distracted by me, clearly. I almost fell asleep, y'all. I know I set an alarm, but sheesh. I was out. I was almost out. I was like, where are we? What's going on? So we'll do the last couple seconds of laying here, relaxing. Oh, perfect. Well done. Thank you, Lee. Alright, so anytime you guys need healing energy, let me know, reach out. I do offer a free energy healing that I just love to send to people. Me distracted? No. I've gotten much better. Qigong is, and getting in a good routine and taking my focus vitamin, which I need to do, actually. But doing the right stuff has really, really helped settle me down and help me recognize the importance of staying on task, especially while streaming. Because otherwise you can stream for hours and you're like, why am I so burnt out? It's like, dude, you just streamed for 4 hours and got one thing done. Yes, yes. And I think that's a big thing with self-healing, is not beating ourselves up anymore for the things that we do, but just like making it a silly game, like, oh, silly human did a silly human thing again. But look how good you've gotten. Okay, Google, stop. Thank you. And just, you know, rewarding ourselves and encouraging ourselves for doing things that work for us, and for loving ourselves enough to say, like, hey, this is something I want to focus on in myself, and shift to a new mindset about it, and not let my old story continue being my new story. And so as we kind of shift that mentality of like, hey, I love myself enough to eat healthy, hey, I love myself enough to remember to take my vitamins, you know, and giving ourselves grace, hey, I love myself enough to know that that sweet drink this morning, as good as it tastes, is making my stomach feel bad, so I'm gonna stop drinking it and grab a bottle of spring water, you know, and making these little adjustments as we can get quieter, and like, we're not listening to that programmed voice in our heads, we're hearing our body's wisdom speaking to us and saying, Carly, this is what you need right now. Hey Carly, I know you're starting to feel sick to your stomach. Let's do the seated healing Qigong practice instead, you know, and making these minor adjustments that may seem insignificant to most people, but are big moments, because, you know, we're celebrating ourselves, we're choosing ourselves, putting ourselves first in a loving way that also helps other people, you know? So if anybody, I hope you got benefit from this Qigong practice. If you missed it, we're gonna save the VOD, we'll share it, and we can watch it for the next 2 weeks, unless Twitch changed that. I don't know if they made it longer or anything when they made their changes, but we're going to find somebody to raid. We're going to see who is online, which I know it's early, so there's not going to be a ton. We've got ASMR. Oh my gosh, we're going to do some ASMR. I love Razor Red. She's so cool. She's super cool. So we're going to raid over there. Thank you guys for being here. I love you so much. I wish I didn't. Oh, it's so cute. So, so cute. Oh my gosh. I'm excited to see you stream some more. I haven't caught you in a while, but always happy to be in your streams and enjoy. Chupacabra Chola. Ooh, I don't know them. Let me see. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Taco, I'm so glad you're still here. Okay, let me look up Chupacabra. That's so funny. My best friend and I have a inside joke about Chupacabra. She's streaming tarot. She thinks just like me. Like, we have twin minds. Oh, nice. Let's see if I can spell that, though. Oh, yeah. That's easy. Chupacabra. That's underscore. You and I have twin souls. That's what it is. Chupacabra underscore Chola. Okay. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. Are you freaking kidding me? What the heck?
So I hope that,
I love this.
Yeah, it helped you a bit.
I love this energy. Oh my god, we're so going here. Perfect suggestion. Thank you. Let's go, friends. A new friend to love. Everyone, give them lots of love. Let's do our exclamation point raid, because that'll come up with our raid message that we can use. Nebulous Taco is the friggin' best. Not me over here spelling. What am I missing? What am I missing in chat right now? Taco, of course, you and I have twin souls. What's that sound out there? If there's mice in my kitchen, you better leave. I'm coming to get you. Thank you. I knew you'd like her, I really do. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You guys are awesome. Not me over here spelling it out loud. Spelling raid out loud. Or spelling chupacabra out loud. Yeah, I can't hear you at the moment, but hopefully soon. All right, let's see. Chupacabra chola raid. Let's go. All right, I'm excited. Thank you all for being here. Like I said, if you did miss the stream, you can come on back and watch the VOD. So, love you so much. Thank you for the suggestion. I'm super excited. I'll go ahead and copy the raid message as well, because that's important. And we'll get back in that stream. Woop woop. All right. We'll see you later. Love you. Thanks for being here. Gosh, that piece of labradorite is stunning. Oh, it's so pretty. All right, brr, I need to put my sweater back on. I'm cold again. Time to go to work. I wish I could take another hot bath before I leave.
Just because I don't like telling people what to do with their money.
Thank you. Thank you for being here. You guys are awesome. Appreciate it. See your butt later. Thanks. Have a great weekend. Yes, have a good weekend, everybody. Thanks for your time and your energy and your lovely, lovely love. Send her stars. Good morning. I'm so sorry. We're just raiding out, but exclamation point raid if you want to copy that raid message. And thank you for popping in. Popping in. We're about to raid out. And there's no stopping us. Hopefully. Hopefully it works. I know there's been some twitching on glitch, but hopefully it goes through just fine. Right? Sending positive love. Thank you, Taco. Appreciate you. I love all you cuties, and I'll see you soon. And today's Friday, so happy weekend. Weekend is here. Whether you work or don't work too hard. Them's the rules. Here, we made it. I love you guys. Bye. Bye.